familiarize you with close quarter line play. And then that you work your disarms from that flow. It serves as a, we'd use the word playground. To learn some, what are you already learning? You know those little sandboxes you have in the playground? Okay, what is a kid when he goes in, what's he really learning? He's learning how to play with others. He's learning how different muscular coordination, what they call big muscle coordination, shoulder. But he doesn't realize it, because he's just what? Playing. Okay, you're just in there playing. It's not for real. Because it actually, by that time, by three exchanges at that distance, there is definitely, has to be trade. And knife fighting for trade is no trade at all. Big hunk for little hunk still hurt, right? So there is definitely a trade, but that's to familiarize you what can be accomplished and what can be done, and you learn your disarms, you learn your throws, you learn your takedowns, and your arm locks from that position, okay? All right, now Kathy, I want you to go up again, so you, okay, now I want you to trade places, okay? All right, watch again, okay? See the scoop? Terry is going where? Kidney. Go up to the throat next time, see? Now he's gonna go over again. He's gonna take it down. Okay, that is the play. Now, like in stick fighting, you have a breakout, a breakout. Okay, now, go in. See, high, low, Kathy, that's it.
Oh.
Okay, high, low, get back. You go high, okay, that's it. Fake high, and low, see? That's it, you catch it. See? Now that's what they call break in, break out. And still simulates long-range knife fighting into close-quarter knife fighting. It's a game, but it's a very good game to play. All right, any questions? Okay, let's try it for about 3 minutes, okay? I want you to play back and forth, and then automatically switch the grips. Okay, all right. But the man with the, this, mine, this in the heaven position is sort of like feeding like Numerado, or he's feeding the energy, right? So on a single direct attack, she's gonna slash, and then we just continue in the flow, right? When I go down low, because I'm gonna go like that, she'll, oh, give me an awesome, hold in. Not the doom gun, it's awesome. See what she's doing? She, because when I face her, see how she picks up the leg, and it's close enough to her diaphragm, all right? So you have high, low, see, right? You have low, and then high, see? And then when you get here, see, then you just go in the flow, see? And you know how to go in and out. See, every time I take my leg out, she stabs it, see? That's the exercise. We're gonna insert the leg, all right? So we keep the leg, obviously, you would keep the leg at knee level, shin level, inner thigh, groin. Because the higher you kick, the more she has to play the dagger up here. All right, in other words, let's say we're flowing. And take this slow so you can see what we're doing, see? Okay, I'm gonna break out, see? See that? That's it. You go past the leg, don't go on unless you have a rubber knife. You got it? Okay, let's try it. First side go 1 minute, like this. Next side go 1 minute. Okay? All right, ready? You know you're sometimes training with wood knife, or you're training with rubber knives. We've had, hopefully, we haven't had any injuries at our academy so far. Okay, but it's always good to wear the, I have my students buy their racquetball eyeglasses. We spar strictly with no contact with the face. Even we have them wear the racquetball, right? Then the other ones are sort of like welding glasses. So at least even the rubber dagger, because you know, an injury, you don't want an injury, something like that. Okay, then a very good, the ones with the plastic are very, very good, but it fogs up when you start to spar after. About a minute and a half, you can't see it unless you had a windshield wiper to see it. So it's good to have protection. You know, that's really funny because this thing here, even it's wood, it still hurts, because if they just would tick it like that, you know, it's still going to hurt. Okay, so what I might want you to do right now, and some people have this, but I'm just going to spend 2 minutes on this because we're going to do the cover and slash. The cover and slash drill is if we're in tight and she can't back up. See, this is cover and slash. See, I'm feeding her the energy here on the cover and slash. Okay, I feed this line, she covers and slash, and then I feed that line. Then I feed this line, feed this line. Then I feed the center line, I feed this line here, I feed this line here. You just take all the lines, just go around in a circle. We are training the person with the heaven position, this is heaven position here, is feeding, and then you're getting practice trapped. Okay, let's go 1 minute for one side. Okay, that's cover. and slash. When you come and slash, you come either backhand, see? You either come backhand, good, or overhead. Okay, when you do overhead, you can also put the overhead on that side. So the minute you come like that, see, and that way you find it whether your hand is here or whether your hand is over here. Okay, all right, let's try it. First side's gonna be cover the rear hand. Okay, so when I, when you pull a soot and I come out like that, okay, let's say she comes to this position, okay? Okay, so when I punch this hand here, that's the slash. The first one is here. Passing that and you throw. Okay? Alright, look at it again in slow motion. One. Okay, and I go like that. And at that point I throw the punch. See? It goes past the neck. Yeah, that's right, past the neck. And then throw. Alright? Any questions on the first one? Okay, let's try it up there, okay? Go past the neck and throw. Right? And that's the first one here. Okay, second one. That's the lock, and that's the break. After you break this, you can throw it, or you can just break it here, and then dump over here. Okay? All right, any questions? You go like this, see the hand? So if sometimes your hand will be on the outside of that punch, sometimes your hand will be on the inside of the punch. See, so when I just swing it like that, see, headbutt, see the hand, thrust, then you bend it here like that. Now some people are not that flexible. So you work on this one, or you break it here. Or you release it, like if you're here like that, and your hand is like that, just release it here, see the punch? And throw here. Okay, that's the other one. Because you can break it here, or at least a good wrench. Or the throw, and just gently move here. So, boom, okay? All right, any questions up there? Got it? Okay, let's try it up there. Okay. You make the high back, look at it again. Inward. Go back and high back in. Okay, now I come in with the diver, backhand thrust. Okay, meaning to say that she would smash my hand here, go high, and then catch this one here, and then come back like that. All right, let's just try it.